Hi, and welcome back to the third and last part of Lesson 8, Level 3, where we'll analyze the 200 rows of simulation data that we produced in the last video. As it sits here, while this big 200-row, two-variable data table is indeed awe-inspiring, I'm not exactly sure what it's trying to tell me, so I need to come up with a way to analyze it in order to answer our original question of what marginal net income can we expect for the new product line for each of these different selling prices. Let's come up here above this awesomeness and create an analysis area. This area will let us see what the data is telling us as opposed to looking through all of this to try to answer our question. We'll calculate the average, the maximum, the minimum expected results, as well as the standard deviation and whatever else we can think of for all these selling prices here. As you can see here, I've built this simulated probability statistics area for us using formulas that we learned back in lessons 1 and 2. For each of these selling prices, I've calculated the average of this column of simulated data, along with the standard deviation, the maximum, and the minimum expected outcomes. For a selling price of $99.99, I have these formulas that summarize our probable outcomes. To complete this analysis table, because I have my mixed referencing set correctly in each of these formulas, I'm able to drag all four of these formulas across, and now I have a pretty complete picture of what pre-tax income I can expect, as well as worst and best cases here. So now, based upon the simulated results of 200 likely iterations of data, if I want to verify my formulas here, I can click on the Control tilde, and I see everything at a glance. Notice all of these weird table formulas down here. We've never discussed an actual table function because the user cannot create or use a table function. This function is only used when we use Excel to create a data table. So let me toggle back to our actual output by hitting the Control tilde again. Looking at this, one additional thing that I might want to know might be how many or what percent of these 200 iterations were actually profitable. To do that, I'll come down here to the next row and type in percent profitable. And then come here to the adjacent cell, equals count if, parentheses, this big long range, comma, double quote, greater than or equal to zero, double quote, parentheses. And then I could divide that by 200 since there's 200 rows in the data table, but I'm not a big fan of that if the data table increases in size. So let me, instead of that 200, do a count of this same range of cells again and hit enter. That gives me this decimal. Let me format that as a percentage. And I'll copy this across, and there you go. We can see that by performing the simulation and analyzing the resulting statistics on these simulated results, we can quantify our likely outcomes. If we keep hitting the F9 key to re-randomize everything, we see that the overarching break-even point in our pricing is where the average goes from red to black. It doesn't typically change much, so I think that 200 samples is enough so that I can trust the output of our data table. This re-randomizing is kind of annoying, though, and if I'm needing to make reports or screenshots or charts or something based upon these values here in this analysis table, I need them to stop moving around on me, so I'll go back up to the calculation options and make them automatic except for the data table. And now I have a steady state answer that I can analyze, copy, paste, and report, whatever. Alright, that's it for Lesson 8. We'll see you in Lesson 9 where we learn more decision-making capabilities that are built into Excel. We'll use the solver model. See you then.